Greetings, my friend. Welcome back to Space Enjoyer. Today we know that there are billions of galaxies in the universe that contain enormous amount of stars, planets, and other space objects. In fact, galaxies don't travel in space separately. Particularly, they form so-called galaxy clusters, structures that consist of anywhere from hundreds to thousands of galaxies that are bound together by gravity. And of course, galaxies and clusters interact among themselves. But what actually happens when two or more galaxies meet each other? In this video, we will try to figure it out. The interaction between galaxies can be very diverse. It depends on their physical characteristics, spatial structure, relative velocities, and so on. Mutual gravity can affect the shape, movement of matter and stars, the processes of star formation, and, in some cases, the exchange of matter between galaxies. Interacting galaxies are characterized by the presence of tails, bridges, and emissions of matter. Generally, galactic interactions can be divided into four different types, which may change over time depending on the conditions. So the first type of interaction that we will discuss is interaction with a satellite. A giant galaxy interacting with its satellites actually is a common case. A satellite's gravity could attract one of the primary spiral arms. A large galaxy, in turn, can attract part of the satellite's matter. A similar phenomenon is observed with the Andromeda Nebula and its small satellite, the dwarf elliptical galaxy M32. M32 is located 5 kiloparsecs from the center of M31 and has already lost most of its substance. Alternatively, the secondary satellite can dive into the primary galaxy, as in the Sagittarius dwarf elliptical galaxy diving into the Milky Way. That can even possibly trigger a small amount of star formation. Such orphaned clusters of stars were sometimes referred to as blue blobs before they were recognized as stars. Actually, I've even created several two-dimensional simulations of galaxy interactions using the classical theory of gravity and Python. Of course, it doesn't take into account relativism, the presence of dark matter, and many other complex effects. But it somehow demonstrates what could happen as a result of some galactic interactions. Here you can see an interaction between a huge galaxy and a very small one. Of course, time is accelerated millions of times. As you can see, a small galaxy was a satellite for a long time. But after that, it was consumed by a large galaxy. And here we've come to another case of galaxy interactions, galactic cannibalism. Galactic cannibalism is the second common case that occurs in the universe, which refers to the process in which a large galaxy, through tidal gravitational interactions with a companion, merges with that companion, that results in a larger, often irregular galaxy. The most common result of the gravitational merger between two or more galaxies is an irregular galaxy, but elliptical galaxies may also result. It has been suggested that galactic cannibalism is currently occurring between the Milky Way and the large and small Magellanic clouds. Streams of gravitationally attracted hydrogen arcing from these dwarf galaxies to the Milky Way is taken as evidence for the theory. Another type of interaction between galaxies is so-called galaxy harassment. Galaxy harassment is an interaction between a low luminosity galaxy and a brighter one that takes place within rich galaxy clusters, where galaxies are moving at high relative velocities and suffering frequent encounters with other systems of the cluster by the high galactic density of the latter. Harassment can disturb or even radically change the morphologies of the galaxies involved, often inducing new bursts of star formation. Asymmetrical galaxies, disturbed galaxies, warps, bars, and tidal tails can all be produced through galaxy harassment. For example, the Cartwheel galaxy was similar to our own Milky Way until quite recently, when a smaller galaxy plowed through its center. This harassment has created spokes of stars and gas and a bright blue ring of new star formation, resulting in a wheel-like appearance for the galaxy and its descriptive name. Galaxy harassment often causes the conversion of low-luminosity spiral galaxies into dwarf spheroidals and dwarf ellipticals. And finally, we've come to galaxy collision. Colliding galaxies is also a common phenomenon during galaxy evolution. The extremely tenuous distribution of matter in galaxies means these are not collisions in the traditional sense of the word, but rather gravitational interactions. Colliding may lead to merging if two galaxies collide and don't have enough momentum to continue traveling after the collision. As with other galaxy collisions, the merging of two galaxies may create a starburst region of new stars. In that case, they fall back into each other and eventually merge into one galaxy after many passes through each other. If one of the colliding galaxies is much larger than the other, it will remain largely intact after the merger. The larger galaxy will look much the same, while the smaller galaxy will be stripped apart and become part of the larger galaxy. When galaxies pass through each other, unlike during mergers, they largely retain their material and shape after the pass. And now I want to share with you some more beautiful images and captures of unique galaxy interactions. Let's take a look at the result of two more simulations I've created, which illustrate two types of galaxy collision. And now you know what happens when galaxies meet each other. Thank you for your attention. If you want to see more of such videos, please leave a like, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment and share with your friends. And I'll see you soon.